Good morning, students. Today we are starting off with a new chapter, that is acids, bases and salts. Elements combine together in various proportion to form compounds. So elements are the one that combine together in definite amount to give rise to compounds. For example, you have hydrogen, and hydrogen is an element, and chlorine is an element. They combine together to form a compound known as HCl, or it is also known as hydrochloric acid. Compounds can be grouped on the basis of their taste or their reactions with the other substances. So the compounds which are obtained by the combination of an element, they can be grouped based on their taste or their reactions with the other substances. For example, vinegar, raw lemon, tamarind. These are sour in nature and these are known as acids. Latin word acidus means sour. Baking powder is bitter. As compounds that are bitter to taste and soapy in touch, they are known as bases. Even washing soda is a base. For example, the substances that are bitter to taste, they are basic in nature. They are known as bases. For example, you have neem leaves, though they are bitter. Bitter gourd, they are bitter. So they all come under bases, as well as they are soapy to touch. Common salt, it is salty. It is neither sour nor bitter. So when acid and base combines, it gives rise to salt. Acids. In 1800, a Swedish scientist known as Svante Arrhenius, he put forth certain theories. And what were those theories? Water can dissolve many compounds by dissociating them into ions. Now water is able to dissolve almost all the substances. That's why it is known as a universal solvent. How can it dissolve the substances? By breaking down the compounds into ions. For example, NaCl. Now NaCl is common salt. Now this breaks down into Na plus and Cl minus in presence of water. So water can dissolve many compounds by dissociating or breaking them up or separating them into ions. Now what are these ions? Ions are charged particle. So Na plus is a charged particle. Cl minus is a charged particle. So ions are nothing but the charged particles. So they are formed by the breaking down of compounds. Now acids contain hydrogen that dissolved in water to give the positive hydrogen ion. Example of an acid is HCl. Now HCl breaks down to give rise to H plus and Cl minus. Now HCl is an acid because it is giving rise to hydrogen ion. This is according to Arrhenius. Arrhenius said that whenever you dissolve an acid in water, it gives rise to H plus. Now NaCl, does it give rise to H plus? No. So this is not an acid. For example, H2SO4, it is sulfuric acid. So it does dissolve, so it breaks down to give rise to a hydrogen ion. So sulfuric acid is an acid. Nitric acid, the formula is HNO3. So it breaks down to give rise to hydrogen ion. So according to Arrhenius, the acids are the one that gives rise to hydrogen ions. Properties of acid is because of H plus ions. So whatever property acid is exhibiting, example, it is sour to taste. So all this is because of H plus ions. Now, what are the source of acids? One is mineral acids. Prepared artificially. So this is prepared artificially from minerals found in the earth. Example, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid. These are also known as inorganic acid. So all these acids are prepared artificially, or it is man-made. Next, organic acids. It is found in plants and animals. Example, citric acid, acetic acid, lactic acid, formic acid. Citric acid, we know it is found in lemon. Acetic acid, vinegar. We also have lactic acid and formic acid. So, these are all the organic acids. Strength. Strong acids. These are the acids which dissociate completely in water to give rise to large number of hydrogen ions are called strong acid. So, when an acid is dissolved in water, if it gives rise to large number of hydrogen ions, it is called as strong acid. Weak acid. Acids which do not dissociate completely in water. It means when dissolved in water, not many H plus ions are given or they are not broken down completely. Such acids are known as weak acids. Example, acetic acid, carbonic acid, formic acid. For strong acid, it is H2SO4, HNO3, nitric acid, sulfuric acid. These are examples of strong acids. Quantity of water in an acid. So, concentrated acids. Under this, we have two categories. First one is concentrated acid. It has got very less amount of water. Such acid is known as concentrated acid. Example, sulfuric acid is usually found in concentrated form. So, whenever sulfuric acid is found or it is made, it is found in concentrated form. It means it has got very less amount of water. Dilute acid. Acid is dissolved in large quantity of water. So, here more amount of water is present in dilute acid. Less amount of H plus ion, but more amount of water. So, the strength of the acid is also very less in dilute acid. Now, let's study few of the characteristics of acids. These are sour to taste. They are soluble in water. Blue litmus paper. See, to indicate the presence of acid or a base, we have what is called as litmus paper. It is made up of lichen. Hopefully, you remember what is lichen. And lichen, litmus paper is formed from the lichens or made from the lichens. So, litmus paper is used as an indicator to test for acid and base. So, it turns blue litmus paper to red. Then, methyl orange is also an indicator to test the presence of acid. It turns to pink. Phenolphthalein is also an indicator. So, in presence of an acid, there is no effect on it. Remember, whether it's litmus paper, methyl orange or phenolphthalein, these are all indicators to test the presence of acid or a base. These are generally colorless. Strong acids called blisters. Blisters are nothing but the swelling with pus. Corrosive means it can damage the skin and can destroy materials like wood, paper, cloth, iron, aluminium, etc. That is why they are stored in glass. So, usually we see strong acids are stored in glass. Okay, because the glass is not so very reactive, we should never add water to acid. Suppose if we add water to acid, then what will happen is lot of heat is being released. And this is an exothermic reaction. So, exothermic reaction, lot of heat is being released outside, so the glass jar might break and it might cause damage. That's why we are not supposed to add water to acid. We can add acid to water drop by drop. Okay, this will not cause any damage. Acid can be added to water drop by drop, so that it gets time for the heat to be equally distributed. Here, what is happening at a stage? You're just adding water to acid, so lot of heat is generated. and it might cause damage. But if you do the other way around and add acid drop by drop to water, there is no damage that is caused. This is to do with the characteristic of acid. Uses of acids. It is used as a fire extinguisher or to extinguish fire. Now, when acid reacts with carbonates, it gives rise to carbon dioxide and water. Okay, remember this equation, it is very important. So, this particular technique is used in the fire extinguisher. Remember this acid, when it reacts with carbonate, carbon dioxide and water is being produced. And carbon dioxide is the one that helps us to extinguish the fire. Now, common fire extinguisher is a foam spray type. It produces foam and you can spray it. That's why it's known as foam spray type. It is used in homes, offices, schools, lifts, etc. So, when you look at fire extinguisher, it is made up of a metal cylinder with a nozzle. Now, what is nozzle? Nozzle is a device. It is used to control the amount of spray or the foam that has to be released. Inside the cylinder are chambers. So within the metal cylinders are chambers. Now there is sulfuric acid in the inner chamber and sodium carbonate in the outer chamber. So in the inner chamber, what is present? Sulfuric acid is there, and in the outer chamber, what is present? Sodium carbonate. So when the cylinder is inverted or when you tilt the cylinder, the nozzle is pressed. There is a pressure that is exerted on the nozzle. So sulfuric acid is present in the inner chamber. It reacts with the sodium carbonate which is there in the outer chamber to give rise to sodium sulfate and carbon dioxide. It extinguishes the fire and water. So, carbon dioxide being heavier than air settles on the fire and cuts off the supply of air and extinguishes the fire. So, what does the carbon dioxide do? It settles on the fire because it is heavier than air and immediately it cuts off the supply of air and thereby extinguishing the fire. Acidity. Acidity is a very common problem or ailment found in many people. Excessive secretion of hydrochloric acid in the stomach is a cause of the acidity. HCl helps in the digestion of food by providing an acidic medium to stomach. See, HCl when it is present in normal amount helps in the digestion of food. Okay, but what causes acidity or increased production of acid? It is tension, overeating, spicy food or empty stomach. And this results in excessive secretion of acid, results in ulcers. These are nothing but wounds. So how can we reduce acidity? By taking base. So base tries to neutralize the acid. So acidity can be reduced by taking chilled milk. Milk is a base, or antacid tablet. Antacids are also base. So this is how acidity can be reduced.